His name is now displayed with pride.
It's the first time I've seen this, and I'm kind of more than honoured. It's like emotional as well.
But there was a time Paul Canoville wasn't made so welcome. Chelsea's first black player suffered racist abuse from fans and teammates.
What was it like being a Chelsea player and being abused by your own fans and even your own players?
Difficult, hurtful. It made me have to play twice as good or twice as better than my teammates just to try to be accepted. That's how I felt. It was always a battle. Don't get me wrong, it was a battle.
Canoville joined Chelsea in 1981, but was forced out after 5 years after a dispute with a white player. Now fans affectionately call him King Canners, and the club have underlined their respect for him by naming this suite after him.
Do you think this is a way of the club saying sorry to you in some form?
Oh, that's a question. Could be. Don't know. I think the club recognises, most definitely, as that was the old regime, this is the new regime.
In the 80s, DJ Trevor Nelson watched Canoville play and heard the abuse.
As glorified and fantastic and incredible as football is today, it's had a lot of flaws in the past, and this is one of them. And I think Chelsea, this is them, getting down on one knee and saying, we are sorry, let's move forward. Since Paul, we've had some incredible black iconic players at this club. We had the first black manager to lift the FA Cup in Ruud Gullit. One of our icons is Didier Drogba. I think we've had more successful black players at this club than any other club in terms of what they've achieved. So, yeah, if they ignored him, it would be wrong. It'd be really wrong.
He loves Chelsea. He's been an advocate for Chelsea, and he's, you know, he's been very loyal to them as well. Considering what he's been through, he's never left their side. So, well done, Paul.
He did go through a lot. Yes. And I'm very proud that Chelsea did acknowledge him for what he did in those days when he was going through a rough time.
When you were getting racist abuse from your own fans, would you at that moment ever imagine there'd be such a big suite named in your honour?
I would never thought that. You know what? It's an honour. Today is emotional for me, really. Yeah, here we are, Canoville suite, and a big suite, one of the biggest suites in Chelsea, Stamford Bridge.
And 40 years after his debut against Crystal Palace, Chelsea face the same team this Saturday. Rags Martel, ITV News, Stamford Bridge.